Me llamo John Victor Watson y me gradúo ahora en mayo con una licenciatura en ingeniería electrónica y también una en lenguaje aplicado con un enfoque al español. It's actually when I got here, I knew I wanted to study language. And when I found out about all the opportunities that were available to students to go abroad, I decided I wanted to get my minor in Spanish. I went on the Mexico and Madrid LBAT program one summer and then came back to Georgia Tech before spending a semester at La Universidad Politécnica de Valencia, taking electrical engineering courses in Spanish. Some people approach it with the attitude that English has sort of become an international language and that other folks learn to speak our language, but what I've really found is that the ability to communicate in two different languages or more, if you're interested in that, it really helps you make people more comfortable when they're interacting with you. You're able to go into their home arena where they're more comfortable. You can kind of interact with them on a more personal level. Well, I think the greatest thing about this program is that it has a lot of flexibility built into it. You can really choose the electives, the upper level courses you want to take. It's not a literature heavy program. There's a lot of sort of science related options. One thing I really enjoyed studying is the linguistics, which is sort of the science behind language. I went to the ECE Career Fair this past January, and I kind of realized there were hundreds of the world's best electrical engineering students there. But there was probably only one that was simultaneously pursuing a language degree and had this particular set of extensive international experiences. And when I went up to talk with the employers, that's kind of what they went right to. They were interested in people that had spent so much time abroad. And one of the things that I noticed about myself was that I sort of passed by some of the traditional engineering firms and started to go towards the more internationally oriented companies. I was talking with the Department of State, some of the international consulting firms, and in those kind of jobs they require these kind of skills. Probably the neatest thing are just the sort of random opportunities that have presented themselves while I've been overseas. I ended up in Rome on Easter weekend without really meaning to. I was in Norway for their National Independence Day, and of course I was in Spain when they won the World Cup this past year. Georgia Tech is a little bit unique in that there's not a foreign language requirement, and that has two implications. One is you don't have to study language. The other is that if you choose to do so, there's a very select group of students that are interested in the topic. The faculty are excellent, and they're willing to interact with you on a one-on-one basis, both in and outside of classes. And so really the sort of foreign language resources available to you here are just outstanding.